Welcome to MedVidsMadeSimple. We just reached 35,000 subscribers on this channel and we are on our way towards 50,000 subscribers. So please hit the like and subscribe buttons right now, it's a small favor. It involves a lot of efforts and multitasking to be making these videos, trust me. So please do consider hitting that subscribe button, which just takes less than a fraction of a second to do so. And let's lie towards 50,000 subscribers ASAP. Scabies is caused by mites called as Sarcoptes scabies. It is a water wash disease, which means it occurs in areas with poor water supply and poor hygiene. Apart from poor hygiene, overcrowding, getting in contact with fomites, which means objects like towels and bed sheets of infected people, and sexual transmission from someone who has untreated scabies can also lead to scabies. There will be excessive itching, and it is especially so much in night, called as nocturnal itching, and there will be skin lesions like papules, vesicles, and excoriated lesions which occur due to repeated scratching. You can see these mites digging burrows in the skin, especially in areas like finger web spaces and abdomen. The female mites only can dig burrows in stratum corneum layer of skin and lays eggs there. The problem is there will be allergic manifestations due to these eggs, feces of mites inside skin and dead mites inside skin, all being some antigens inside the body causing allergy or hypersensitivity in some patients. The area commonly involved by scabies include axilla, elbow, wrist, groin, and these areas if connected by dots resemble a circle, so this is called as circle of HEBRA. Now there's a special type of scabies called Norwegian scabies, which is seen in those with some diseases like diabetes, AIDS, neurological disorders or mentally ill people, or in leprosy, where there will not be classical itching and these patients are unaware of having scabies. So there will be exaggerated symptoms like so much of crusting, hyperkeratosis and erythema. There will be millions of mites on these patients. Scabies is diagnosed clinically, the typical history of nocturnal pruritus and presence of scabies in close relatives and by presence of burrows in finger spaces. There's a method called ink method where you basically apply dye over the skin and this burrows areas will be stained excessively by the dye. Dermoscopy can also be used to visualize these burrows closely. Now there are certain complications like these burrows and skin lesions can get infected with some bacteria or because of repeated irritation there can be development of eczema in these sites. In the Norwegian type of scabies, lymphangitis and septicemia can occur rarely. Treatment is usually by 5% permethrin cream, which is applied below the neck of the patients, and it is advised to be applied in night only once a week. It is important to treat all the family members who lives with the patient because there can be recurrence or new cases because of close contact with this patient, so it's important to treat all close contacts like family members. Other treatment options are linden lotion, ivermectin and benzobenzoate, and to overcome the severe itching and allergic symptoms, antihistamines are usually prescribed. Moreover, proper hygiene by bathing regularly and washing clothes properly and eliminating the mites from all possible fomites is very crucial in preventing further recurrences. You can earn a couple of bucks here on this link to help me make more videos for which you will get shout out in the next video. And please hit the like button and subscribe button as it really takes less than a fraction of a second to do it and it will really mean a lot to me. And yeah, let us light towards 50,000 subscribers very quickly, so hit the subscribe button please. Once again, thank you so much for watching. You can watch the psoriasis video or urticaria video by clicking the links you see here. And also, don't forget to subscribe for more videos in all subjects in med school. Take care, I'll see you in my next video. Bye.